Hi students, in this video we are going to discuss about trigonometric ratios of compound angles.
Trigonometric ratios of compound angles. What is a compound angle? So let me take, if you consider theta or 30 degrees or 40 degrees, that is called simple angles. Let me consider compound angle. Sum of any two angles or difference of any two angles will becomes compound angles. Let me take sine, trigonometric ratio, sine alpha plus beta is equals to, we have to find the formula. Sine alpha plus beta formula is sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta. So how to derive this formula, we have to learn in this video. Let me consider first a unit circle or a circle with radius r. So in this, so we are going to consider an x-axis and y-axis, this is x-axis and this is y-axis, x dash and y dash. So let me consider the origin point. The origin point is a fixed point. From this fixed point, one ray is rotating here. So the initial position on the positive x-axis, suppose this ray is rotating anti-clockwise direction, the first position of this ray will be here. Let me consider this is A position. So it's making an angle alpha, then again further the ray is rotating towards anti-clockwise direction, this ray is reaches, here. This is B point. So this further amount of rotation, of a ray with a fixed point O, is called beta. So here total value will becomes alpha plus beta. So this total value we have to see. So to find this, we are going to apply the trigonometric ratios. To find alpha plus beta, sine alpha plus beta, we need trigonometric ratios. To find any trigonometric ratio, we need a right angle triangle. That's the reason why we are going to draw a perpendicular from A to x-axis. And B to x-axis. Now we are getting, this is M point perpendicular, N perpendicular, and we are taking one more perpendicular from B to A. This is one more perpendicular we have to take, this perpendicular as N. And also, so we are getting three triangles now, three right angle triangles. So one is OAM triangle, OBN triangle, and OBN, this is MN, OP, this one considered as P. So OBP triangle, there are three triangles are existing, So we have to know, draw one more triangle from P point to BN. We need to draw one more perpendicular. This can be called as Q. This is about the diagram. So now, for our better understanding, so we are going to apply. Consider triangle. What is alpha plus beta? Alpha plus beta is an angle in a triangle ONB or ONB. From triangle ONB, sine alpha plus beta is equals to, let me consider the circle whose radius is r. This is r radius and this is also r radius. So this may consider as r is radius now. Okay, now sine alpha plus beta is equals to opposite side to alpha plus beta by hypotenuse. What is opposite side to alpha plus beta? This is bn by hypotenuse OB. So this can be written as bn by r. bn by r. Now bn can be splitted into two forms. That is, bn can be written as, in the place of bn we can write as bq plus qn by r. So this bq by r plus qn by r, like that we are going to split this fraction. This fraction will be splitted like this, bq. Where bq by r, where is bq? Bq is this one, and bq by r, then qn is this one. But qn, there is no right angle triangle for qn, so that is the reason why qn is equals to pm. So since perpendiculars in the same side are equal, so that's the reason why bq by r plus, in the place of qn can be written as pm. That is pm by r. So we have to write for better understanding. Qn is equals to pm since it is from diagram. Now bq by r plus pm by r. bq by r since qm by r. Okay, now we are going to consider which type of triangle we have to consider. This is, let us see now. We have to consider triangle O. Okay, this point we are going to consider as, so where it is exactly cuts, we give R, we are taking R, this is R point. Okay, from triangle ONR and triangle ONR and triangle ORAB, these two triangles we have to consider. Triangle ONR and BRA or ABR or RAB, like that we have to consider now. So these two angles are vertically opposite angles. From this angle R is equals to, this is also angle R, because since this is vertically opposite angles. Now this is 90 degrees and this P is 90 degrees. Here angle N is 90 degrees. Oh, okay, this is a angle RPB triangle. So angle P is equals to, since it is 90 degrees, both are perpendiculars. Therefore, so from AA similarity, triangle angle O here becomes angle B. This alpha, so it becomes an alpha. It becomes an alpha. Now, if you consider this R is common for BA side, and this BA is interlinked with BQ. That means here BQ is there. So BQ and R, there is no any relation. BQ and R, there is no any relation because there is no right angle triangle. So where it is right angle triangle with BQ and R, BQ or R, both are commonly related to AB. That's the reason why this ratio will be multiplied by AB. That is BQ by AB into AB by R plus. This is for our, we are going to relation. So there is no, actually there is no relation between BQ and R. Here BQ and R, there is no any relation. So to make it as relative, they make it as meaningful ratio. They make it as meaningful ratio. So BQ and R, both are commonly related with AB. Both are commonly related with AB. That's the reason why I am going to multiply and divide with AB and AB. So now BQ by AB. In the BQ by AB, where it is exactly located in this which triangle? BQ and AB. Here see BQ. So this is BQ and this is AB. So when you consider alpha is an angle, observation angle, AB is opposite to the angle Q. AB is opposite to the angle Q. That is, AB is called hypotenuse. AB is known as hypotenuse. And alpha is an observation angle and AB is hypotenuse. What about BQ? BQ is adjacent side. So adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse is nothing but cos alpha. So we are calling it as cos alpha. This is cos alpha from triangle ABQ. So from triangle PBQ. This is PBQ. Okay, from the PBQ triangle, we are going to consider it as cos alpha. Then AB by R. Where is AB? So AB is this one, R is this one. So AB is opposite to the angle B and R is the hypotenuse. Then AB by R is nothing but opposite side by hypotenuse, that is sine beta. Sine beta. Now PM by R. So where is PM? Where is PM? Here PM and this is R. So where is the common relation? There is no common relation for PM and R. So that's the reason why we are going to divide it. So yes, we have a common OA. OA is a common ray. So OP or OP is, you can consider OP. So OP and PM, there is a relation, and OP and R, there is a relation. So that's the reason why. So PM and R, there is no actually relation. There is no triangle. So between these two sides, that's the reason why. So we are making as a, this ratio as meaningful, we are going to multiply and divide with OP. That is PM by OP into OP by R. So now OP get cancelled, then PM by R. That means we are going to multiply any number or any number to the given ratio. The ratio doesn't change. Multiply and divide. That's the reason why. So we are going to multiply with POP. Now PM by OP. Where is PM? So PM is this one and OP is this one. So PM is opposite to the alpha and OP is a hypotenuse. Then opposite side by hypotenuse is nothing but sine alpha. Sine alpha into, what about OP? OP and R. OP, where is OP? OP is this is and adjacent side to beta, and R is hypotenuse. Adjacent side to beta and hypotenuse. The ratio becomes cos beta. Cos beta. Now it is, now it can be rewrite as sine alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta. This is a formula what we are going to prove. So I hope you understand. So how to find this one? So this is called sine sum. Like that, we are going to get sine difference also. In the place of beta, we are going to apply minus beta, then it becomes minus. That is sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. In the same way, we are going to apply cos alpha plus beta and cos alpha minus beta. When you know sine alpha plus beta and cos alpha plus beta, very easily find tan alpha plus beta. Like that we can. So if you derive one trigonometric ratio, so it is very easy how to derive all the trigonometric ratios by using one trigonometric ratio. Okay, thank you.